एंड केन्स एंड हेलो एरिन्स. दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज एल्काइल हैलाइड एंड एराइल हैलाइड्स. हेलो वर्ड मीन्स हेलोजन एंड एल्केन मीन्स एल्काइल ग्रुप. सो हियर यू कैन राइट इट लाइक दिस, हेलो प्लस एल्केन. यू कैन राइट हियर एनी हेलोजन अलोंग विद एनी एल्केन सीरीज. सपोज यू आर हैविंग मीथेन ग्रुप CH4, वी विल राइट एल्केन सीरीज हियर. दिस इज CH4C2H6, दैट इज CnH2n+2. Write the full alkane series here. This is C3H8, C4H10, C5H12, C6H14. We have methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, hexane. So what we have to do now, we have to eliminate one of the hydrogen atom. You have to write it as methyl, ethyl, propyl, ब्यूटाइल, पेंटाइल, हेक्साइल. नाउ यू कैन राइट एनी हैलोजन विद इट. इट कैन बी फ्लोरीन, क्लोरीन, ब्रोमीन, आयोडीन, एनी हैलोजन यू कैन राइट विद दैम. फाइन, दिस इज हाउ टू राइट हेलो एल्केन्स. नाउ हाउ टू गिव देम नेम्स. It can be given in two ways. One is IUPAC system, that is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, has given certain rules to write. Another is common name system. For IUPAC name system, we write it as haloalkane. It is fluoromethane, chloroethane, bromopropane, idobutane, fluoropentane, chlorohexane. You can complete it like this. This is chloroethane. This is idobutane. Then in common name system, you have to give it name like this. Alkyl halide. Alkyl halide means, how you can write this? This is bromopropane. It can be written like this, propyl bromide. Means first you have to write alkyl. Alkyl is propyl, halide is bromide. So it is propyl bromide. It is chlorohexane. It can be written as hexyl chloride. This is how we can write the names of all haloalkanes. Fine. After that comes the number of haloarenes. How to write the names with compounds having benzene ring in them? First of all, you have to draw the benzene ring. Then write it with halogen. This is fluorobenzene. If chlorine is there, chlorobenzene. Bromine is there, bromobenzene. Iodine is there, idobenzene. Like this. Fine. After that, if there is chain like you have SCH3, CH2, Cl. What is this? It is chloroethane. It is having sp3 hybridization in the series. Second thing, you can have CH2 double bond CH, CH2 Cl. Again, the carbon which is having chlorine attached to it is having sp3 hybridization with it, but the another carbon which is attached to it is having double bond. Fine. This is another group which you have to keep in mind in sp3 hybridization. Then you can have third category in sp3 hybridization, that is you are having benzene ring, you are having ch2 ch, then you have cl here attached. Fine. Here again, carbon which is having chlorine attached to it is having sp3 hybridization, but this carbon with benzene ring is having sp2 hybridization. This type is called as allylic carbon. Then another category is which is having sp2 hybridization. With sp2 hybridization, you can have ch2 double bond ch cl, means the carbon which is having chlorine attached to it is having direct double bond with the another carbon atom. This is vinylic carbon. Again, in benzene ring you can have this type. This carbon is completing two bonds like this. So this is having vinylic carbon. This type is having again direct double bond attached with the benzene ring. This is CHCl. This is type of vinylic. Then you can have sp hybridization. In sp hybridization, benzene which is attached to carbon is having triple bond. This is sp hybridization. Then three types of hybridization we have discussed: sp3, sp2. How you can convert alcohols to alkyl halides? First reaction is reaction of alcohol. I am taking here ethanol with HCl. When ethanol reacts with HCl, H and OH will evolve out water, and remaining product is CH3CH2Cl. This is ethyl chloride. In this way, ethanol can be converted into ethyl chloride. It is done in presence of anhydrous zinc chloride as halogen gas. Second reaction is you have to take ethanol and react it with PCl5. See how to write this. You have to take ethanol, split PCl5 as Cl, PCl3 and Cl. It will become CH3CH2Cl. It will become POCl3 and it will become HCl. So your product is ethyl chloride plus POCl3 plus HCl. Third reaction is you have to take ethanol and react it with PCl3. See, in this reaction we need three molecules of ethanol. Split it like this. And then write PCl3 in front of this like this. It will become CH3CH2Cl. CH3CH2Cl, CH3CH2Cl. So you got three molecules of ethyl chloride along with 1P and 3OH. It forms H3PO3. After that, fourth method in the series is you have to take ethanol and react it with thionyl chloride, SOCl2. See how to write this. You have to split it Cl, SOCl. Cl2 is split as Cl and Cl. It will become CH3CH2Cl. It is SO2 and it is HCl. So it forms ethyl chloride, sulfur dioxide and HCl. In this reaction, sulfur dioxide and HCl both form vapors. They are going upward. Only ethyl chloride is left. So this in this reaction, no problem of separation is left. This is a reaction in which we have converted alcohol to ethyl chloride by different means. First reaction is with HCl, second is with PCl5, third is with PCl3, and fourth is with SOCl2. Out of all the four methods, if it is asked which is best method, you will prefer with thionyl chloride as both are gaseous product, so no problem of separation. Second method of formation of alkyl halide is by substitution reaction. Here I have methane, CH4, reacted with chlorine in presence of sunlight. It will form HCl, and this chlorine takes the place of hydrogen, so it forms methyl chloride plus HCl. In next step, again take this methyl chloride and react it with chlorine. It forms HCl, again it forms dichloromethane, it is CH2Cl2. Again take this dichloromethane and react it with chlorine. It forms HCl, this is trichloromethane, CHCl3. CHCl3 is also called as chloroform. It is used as anesthesia. Kidnappers frequently used it to make someone unconscious. Trichloromethane, that is chloroform, if further treated with chlorine, it forms. These all reactions are taking place in sunlight. HCl is going out, and the fourth place which was left is taken by chlorine. It forms CCl4. It is termed as carbon tetrachloride. It is used as organic solvent. The substances which are not soluble in water, organic compounds which are insoluble in water, can be dissolved well in carbon tetrachloride. This is reaction which takes place stepwise. If there is a factory for the formation of chloroform, you can stop this reaction at third step. If in your factory you want to prepare carbon tetrachloride, you can stop the reaction at fourth step. But if you do the same reaction, that is, I am taking methane in presence of chlorine, in presence of UV light, it will form mixture of products. All the products will form in equal ratio. So your yield will be 25%. If you are having factory of preparation of chloroform, your chloroform will be only 25%, and it is very tough to separate all these four products as their boiling point is very close to each other. If it is asked in an exam, out of sunlight and UV light, which light should be preferred in substitution reaction, then it is always sunlight. Next method for formation of alkyl halide is by reaction of alkenes. prepare alkyl halides by addition reaction. See, if you have symmetrical alkene, you have this ethene, you are adding HCl in it. HCl can be added like H positive, Cl negative. On demand of attacking reagent, this double bond has to shift. It will become like CH2. This is positive, this is negative. As this pair of electron of this bond is shifting to this carbon, it is getting negative charge. And the one from which electron pair is moving away, it is getting positive charge. Similarly, this H positive will come and combine with this negative part. Cl negative will come on this positive part. It will become CH2Cl. This is CH2 and H, CH3. So what you can say it is, this C2H5Cl, that is ethyl chloride. So from ethene you have prepared ethyl chloride. It can come in conversion in exam, that you have to prepare ethyl chloride from ethene. You can prepare by addition of HCl to it. Similarly, if you want to prepare bromide, you can take HBr and so on. And in case of unsymmetrical alkene, if you have here propene, say, you are going to add HCl in it. Now HCl can be added in two ways. Either H positive will attack on this carbon and Cl negative will attack on this carbon, or it can be like this. That H positive will attack on this carbon and Cl negative will attack on this carbon. In both cases, you are getting different products. In this case, you will get 1-chloropropane. In this case, you will get 2-chloropropane. So products will be different. Which product will be preferred? It is given by Markovnikov's rule. Markovnikov's rule states that negative part of attacking reagent goes to the carbon having less hydrogen. So see here, out of these two, across the double bond, you have to see which carbon has less hydrogens. This one. So negative part would preferably attack on this carbon. So your major product will be from this reaction, that is CH3, CHCl and CH3. This is your major product by Markovnikov's addition. And the another one, that is 1-chloropropane, will be formed but in very little quantity. So it is called as minor product. So primary alkyl halide here would be minor product and secondary alkyl halide would be your major product. So out of these two mechanisms, which one it will follow? It will follow this to maximum extent. So it leads to secondary as major product. And if you have here HBr, you are taking here HBr in presence of peroxide. In presence of peroxide, you are going to add HBr in it. Then reverse of Markovnikov's rule will be followed. It is called as anti-Markovnikov's rule. What is now anti-Markovnikov's rule? It is reverse of Markovnikov's rule. It says that negative part of attacking reagent goes to the carbon having more number of hydrogens. So out of these two, it is having more number of hydrogens. So negative part, that is Br negative, will attack on this carbon preferably. So it will form major product as primary alkyl halide. Primary alkyl halide will be here major product. Difference is because it is having free radical mechanism. In this we are following free radical mechanism, and in this we were having carbocation mechanism. This topic you have done in class 11 also. This is mere repetition of it, and here minor product will be your secondary alkyl halide. This would be minor product. So this was method of formation of alkyl halide, in which we are taking alkene, we are adding HCl in it. If it is symmetrical alkene, there is no issue, there would be only one product. But if you are having unsymmetrical alkene, in case of unsymmetrical alkene, now if you want to add HCl in it, it can be added by Markovnikov's rule. It says that negative part of attacking reagent goes to the carbon having less number of hydrogens. So this is having less number of hydrogens, negative part will attack on this. So preferred product will be secondary alkyl halide. But in anti-Markovnikov's rule, you need HBr with peroxide. These two are the mandatory conditions. So primary alkyl halide would be major product. So if in exam you are supposed to prepare one bromopropane, you will prefer anti-Markovnikov's rule. That is, you are going to add HBr in presence of peroxide. But if you want to prepare here two bromopropane, for preparation of 2-bromopropane, you are supposed to take HBr without peroxide. That you have to keep in mind. Hund's-Diker reaction. In Hund's-Diker reaction, you have to take silver salt of, say, acetic acid, you have taken silver salt and combine it with bromine in presence of carbon tetrachloride and reflux it. Reflux means you have to heat it as well as you have to cool it. So break it down in the form of Br and Br. It forms CH3Br, it forms AgBr, and it forms carbon dioxide. So your product will be methyl bromide plus carbon dioxide plus silver bromide. This is Hund's-Diker reaction. Then you have Finkelstein reaction. In Finkelstein reaction, you can do halogen exchange. Means if you are having any another halogen attached with alkyl group and you want to add iodine in it, then what you can do, you can take sodium iodide. Iodine will just replace the alkyl group which was present there. If you are having here ethyl bromide, say, reacting it with NaI, it will form NaBr. And iodine will take its place. This reaction is termed as halogen exchange reaction. What we are doing? We are exchanging the halogen group. Then you have Swartz reaction. Swartz reaction is again halogen exchange reaction, in which you are exchanging your bromide with fluoride group. You are here having silver fluoride. It will form AgBr get here fluoromethane. If you want to get fluoride group here, this halogen exchange reaction can be used. Both are halogen exchange reactions.